It's Miss Angelique, and you're watching Miss Angelique TV, where we talk about everything. And when I mean everything, I mean like throwing hands with your mama and shit. I know a lot of y'all probably was wondering. I wonder who the fuck Angie was fighting. Like, Angie don't fight because Angie don't fight. Like, people don't fuck with me, and you know I don't fuck with people. So I never really had to fight until I was fucking 20 years old. Mama, I love you. If you ever get to watch this, we're good now. I have to just tell the truth, okay? They ask, so tell them the truth, okay, girl? All right. If you have not subscribed yet, please subscribe right now, because you don't want to miss all of these other story times that's getting ready to pop off and stuff, because your girl has been through a lot, like a lot of like dumb stuff and stupid shit. So let's go back to 2013. Me and Freddie, we were living together at the time. My daughter turned 2, and before the birthday party, my mama she was like really, really off. Like, she had been going off on people like randomly. And y'all, my mama is like this Christian woman. Like, she don't curse. She don't listen to like rap music. Like, none of that. She even had me in the church. Like, yeah, like I used to be in church. You know, I may not sound like it or look like it, but bitch, you know, I know a little something, something. Thank you, Jesus. My daughter was turning 2, and we were gonna have a birthday party. My mama went off on her boss like earlier that day, and mind y'all, mama had a good ass job. You feel me? Like, a good job. And so I'm trying to figure out why the fuck she going off on everybody. I let it slide, ain't say shit. Party comes, my mama start tripping, long story short. She get into it with me, and ever since then, our relationship had never really been the same. Now, even before then, mama and our relationship wasn't really the same. Like, whenever I was like younger, like 12, 13, 10, like, around that age, like, we really didn't have a good relationship, because that's another story time. If you want to hear about those stories, please let me know in the comments. So my mama was going through it. She goes through these phases where she starts like ranting on Facebook and like telling people business and stuff like that, and just trying to like expose people, make people look really, really fucking stupid. And so that pissed me off. I was tired of that. So I called her up and I was like, mama, what the fuck, why you doing that? Like, chill out. Of course I didn't say what the fuck, but I was like, mama, I really feel like you need to stop, because girl, like, what are you doing all of that for? Who the fuck you mad at? Don't nobody owe you anything. Why you upset? So that made her mad, obviously, because, you know, she didn't want me. She felt like I was telling her what to do, and she felt like, you know, she was the mama. She had told me one time, she was like, I'm the mama, and you the daughter. And I'm like, okay, yeah, you the mama, but you acting stupid as fuck right now. I'm not gonna sit here and let you just do whatever just because you my mama. Like, girl, we get into it, and so, well, we didn't really get into it. It was just kind of like we exchanged words, basically. And so, that next day, she had called me, and I didn't answer, because I was like, you know what, at this point, I'm not about to answer my phone calls for a minute, because, like, I'm tired of the drama, because she was really, really causing a lot of drama in my family at the time. Not only with me, but like even her mom, her sister, and like other people who was like wasn't even in the same fucking city as us, like causing fucking drama. I decided that I wasn't gonna answer my phone for her for a minute. So I did that, and she called me, and I didn't answer. She called me a couple times, and I didn't answer. So at this point, she left me a voicemail, and the voicemail, I don't remember what it was, but girl, she had said some fucked up shit. To where I said, hold the fuck up, who the fuck is she talking to? And I called her and I went the fuck off on her. And so I'm really, really respectful, especially whenever it comes to my mama and like anybody older than me, you know, but especially my mother. I've never disrespected any adult until this day. She said a lot of horrible stuff to me, and in exchange I'm like, girl, you got me fucked up. And I said what I said, and I hung up the phone, and that was that. A few hours later, I go on her Instagram, because she, at this point, she also was on her Instagram posting pictures and again trying to expose people. And so I saw her posting a picture going, she was on the road, like on the freeway driving, and the caption was like, I forgot what it was, but it indicated that she was coming to Houston. And she was not in Houston at this time. She was actually in New Orleans. I don't know if I mentioned that. I don't think I mentioned that. But at this point, she was in New Orleans. And so after we got into it, I guess she was like, this girl got me fucked up, so I'm about to come to Houston. And I'm on Instagram, and I'm telling Freddie, I'm like, is this girl really coming to Houston? Like, is she for real? Is she really coming to Houston? I didn't think nothing of it, though. I was just like, you know what? I ain't got time for it. I'm about to lay my ass down, go to sleep, and go to work the next day. And that's what the fuck I did. Well, I went to sleep. That's what I did. And I woke up. As far as everything else, I can't say that I did. And I'm gonna tell you why. I was in the bed, y'all know how, like, you know, you check your phone right before you get up or whatever. So I was checking my phone, I was on Instagram, and I saw that my mama, she had posted a picture of the freeway, and the location said highway, well, y'all not gonna know what the fuck I'm talking about, but it said 45, and out here we got a freeway called 45, and I'm like, why the fuck is she on 45? Why is she in Houston? Like, this girl really came to Houston. What is the reason why you coming to Houston? At the time, I didn't know what her intentions were. I shortly found out. So we get up, go outside. And so as soon as Freddie opens the door, my mama, she looking at us and we looking at her. What the fuck? You gonna knock? Like, what the fuck? So it was really, really weird. Like, she scared the fuck out of me. She was in front of my door and she had some clothes, like some kids' clothes in her hand, because she had bought some clothes for the kids or whatever. And she was like, I came to bring the clothes for the kids. I said, no, thank you. Can you please leave? Like, I have nothing to say. And so that right there, long story short, made her mad. She decides that it will be a good idea to run in my fucking shit, to run in my house. And she like pushed me. And so at this point, I'm on the floor and she on top of me. Now, I don't know how the hell she got from off of me, but I was doing something. I'm on the ground and she like by my legs. I don't know how she get by my foot. She's close to my wrist. And so she wouldn't let me fucking go. So I kicked her in her fucking head. I hated that I had to do this. And she bit my fucking finger. Now, I wish I had this fucking picture. If I could find this picture, because I took a picture, I might have it in my email, because I have to email it to the investigator. I don't know. If I have a picture of it, I'm gonna answer it over here. But this goddamn lady bit my fucking finger, y'all. Like, is this a fight or what? Because why is you biting me? I didn't realize she bit my finger, obviously, of course, until after the fact. After I kicked her, I told Freddie, I'm like, get me a knife. Like, I didn't give a damn at this point. You coming in my shit for what? Like, what is you doing? Freddie was like, nah, I'm not about to do that. And my mama was like, go get it for her. Let me see what she gonna do with it. They're still on the floor. After I kicked her, she kind of held my leg down a little bit, like my foot, and kind of, I don't know if she sat on my shit or what, because my shit was hurting afterwards. Freddie, he called the police with them. He was like, they fighting, and start giving them the address and stuff like that. And so whenever that starts to happen, my mama gets up and starts leaving or whatever. And I'm like, don't leave now. Why you leaving? I'm running after her. I'm not running after her because she's walking, but I'm walking behind her outside. No shoes on, no nothing. We just got finished doing what the fuck we was doing on the floor. I forgot what my mama was saying, but she was talking shit and I was talking shit too. And so Freddie was like, nah, stop following her or whatever, because the cops told him to tell me to stop following her, because I wanted to know who the fuck she was with, or if she was with somebody, and what type of, you know, vehicle she was riding in, because where the fuck you think you going? Of course she ends up fucking leaving, and then police didn't come until an hour later. Like, nigga, I could have been dying. Like, what the fuck? The fucking ambulance showed up before cops did. My mama texted me shortly after that, and it was like, LOL, I haven't had a fight since the sixth grade. That was fun. Wow. Did you intend on coming your ass all the way from Louisiana to Houston to do this dumbass shit? Because mind you, that wasn't a fight. I don't know what the fuck that was, and you bit me. So I can't even consider that as a fight, because that was nothing. You didn't punch me, you didn't slap me, you didn't do none of that. Like, a couple hours later, I look on her Instagram, she posts a picture of a Smoothie King cup or whatever, and was like, just got done with a workout with so-and-so. She had tagged my Instagram name, and she tried to make it seem like we really was working out. And so my aunt called me and was like, what's your mama talking about? I thought your mama was in New Orleans. I had saw that she said that y'all just got done working out. I said, look, it wasn't fucking working out. And I ended up telling her what happened. And she was really, really surprised, because nobody knew, like, ever known my mom to act like that. She didn't start acting like that until I was 18 or 19. All them years, my mama had never acted like that. Just all of a sudden, she just changed, and she hasn't been the same since. Like, if y'all want to update on our relationship and stuff, I can, but it's going to obviously be in a separate video. And I almost put a restraining order on her, but because my mama didn't have an address at the time, they couldn't serve her with papers, so it didn't really make sense for me to put a restraining order on her. So that was crazy. I've never, like I said, I've never fought nobody before until that day, and that was my first and only fight. That's that. Y'all asked for it, and I told y'all wanted me to do the story time, and that's what the fuck I did. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to thumbs up. Also subscribe if you haven't already subscribed, because if you're not subscribed, what the fuck you doing? But you need to be subscribed to me. I'm the one to be subscribed to. Thank y'all for watching, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.